And really, truly, Shaq is the reason why we're here at Staples Center. That he was part of the groundbreaking ceremony, putting the shovel in the dirt on this piece of property that some people thought, there's no way sports fans are gonna go to downtown LA to watch a sporting event. And why are we gonna leave the Forum? We've had so much luck there, it's difficult. But this house was built by Shaq, and he actually helped us decorate it as well, because the very first season we played here, we won a championship, and nobody worried about leaving the Forum again, that we could win championships here in this building. The Basketball Hall of Fame rules state that it takes 5 years after you retire to be considered in the Hall of Fame. But Shaq wanted to make a special exception because my father was dying, and he wanted to make sure that he would be remembered as a Laker while my dad was still here. And that was a really important moment for all of us, for my father. And so I appreciate that Shaq thinks of this as home. And when he does come up here, I hope you give him that warm welcome that makes me so proud that he is part of the Laker history. And thank you all for being here tonight. Enjoy.
And then all of a sudden, you're coming to LA. Big person. I mean, was it everything you expected, or was it more than you expected when you made that move from Orlando?
It was actually more. Like, when I was in Orlando, I thought I was going to be in Orlando forever. And we was doing the Olympics in Atlanta, and I saw Jerry West, and he was like, love to have you come play for the Lakers. And I said, okay. And then, at first he offered me one thing, and then he offered me the big one. Like, I couldn't say no to that. But he did something very interesting the first day I got here. The first day I got here in the Forum, he walked me to the middle of the Forum, and he made me look up. And he said, Mr. O'Neal, you could be next to those guys one day, or you could be a bust, and you have to decide. So he put a lot of pressure on me. I know I had big shoes to fill. The great Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Will Chamberlain, but I just wanted to make a name for myself and do it my way. And luckily, I had help, and the great Kobe Bryant was next to me all those years.
I know, you've been asked it a zillion times, and one of the audience members wrote down the question, too, about, did it play out just the way you wanted it to? Would you do things a little bit differently as far as leaving?
Well, I didn't leave, I got traded.
You're right. Get his butt out of town, right?
You have to understand this is a business thing. But, the good thing about the Buff family is they called me and told me. They said, we want to do things different. And I said, I understood. And, we moved on. Of course, when I went away, I was doing the marketing thing, playing it up. But it was never any hard feelings. We always stayed in close communications. But the way Kobe and I handled the situation, I would probably do it the exact same way. And people always ask me all the time, don't you wish you and Kobe would have worked out better? And I ask them, well, 3 out of 4 is not working out pretty good. I mean, pretty good to me. And, we just had to find certain ways to push each other.